course, on the south side are really the two schools that are most in danger, I think, from falling out of 7A. And it's not so much because they're shrinking as it is that Jonesboro's falling at a rapid rate. This battle runs left side on first down across the 45. Great yardage here out to midfield, maybe even to the Woodland side of the field. They'll give him 7 to the midfield stripe, and it'll be 2nd and 3 from there. 47 seconds, clock running, first quarter.
They might have had him bottled up at the 45. And sneaking his way through, got the midfield.
Second down, battles. With those orange shoes, you can spot him from a mile away. Coming right side, trying to get outside. He's got the first down yardage across the 45, breaks a tackle. He's at the 35, and there he goes at the 30, the 25, breaks another tackle at the 20, and balls down inside the 15-yard line. What a great run that time. Tyree Terry was the one with the touchdown-saving tackle. The battles goes for 35. That's the second time we've seen him with a big run tonight. He also had that 31-yard touchdown not long ago.
Yeah, that was a design run the whole way. As soon as he took the snap, he was off and broke a couple tackles. That's going to bring the first quarter to an end.
8 minutes in the books, and our score, Fulbright 8, Woodland 8. This is Woodland Football, sponsored by Freedom 5-1 and Eagle Bank Mortgage. The second quarter, Fulbright and Woodland tied at 8. Fulbright moving inside the red zone at the 15 of Woodland. First down and 10 here for Christian Battles. The Fulbright offense, and they're just going to go with what's got them here. The ball came out. Battles ran, and it came out, and Woodland has it. I think Woodland has it. Waiting for the signal, and they do. Woodland comes away with it. Battles had it knocked away. Xavier Burns is the one who came away with it for the Colts.
It's hard to tell who had it because nobody was really throwing anything at once.
Well, and shot for it about 6 or 7 yards from where Battles actually fumbled it. That play has been such a high percentage play for Fulbright so far. Battles just keeping the ball for 6, 7, 30 yards. And finally, Woodland able to strip it. That's a big play in this game. First down to the 9 for the Colts. Schaefer in the shotgun. He's a hand in motion to his left. Now gets it to the receiver to either side. Gets it to Burns across the 10. Xavier Burns running hard across the 15 and he gets out to the 18-yard line. Burns recovered the fumble a moment ago. Runs for 9 on first down and that gives you some options here as they bring up 2nd and 1.
They're doing a great job on first down.
Woodland needs to get to the 19-yard line. Burns lined up to Schaefer's left. Don't make it to him. Schaefer running right side. He's got the first down across the 20 to 25 and falls forward to the 26-yard line. 8 yards that time for Schaefer. So they run twice on this drive and pick up 17 yards.
The offensive line is doing really nice job.
30. Terry's at the 35. He can move. He's at the 40. The 45 midfield. Tyree Terry into Fulbright territory and down at the 46-yard line.
It almost looked like a catch. Terry came away with the handoff. Holding up a little bit.
26 on the run that time for Terry. It is fun to watch him run and get into the open field.
Yeah, they were playing for the pass. They shifted a couple of
them. They bring Graves in as a running back. We haven't seen that this year. They give it to him, running right side. Charlie Graves gets past the first defender, gets past another. Falls down to the 40-yard line. There's no marking at the 39. They're getting big-time production on first down this time right now.
That's all the difference in the world.
The 30. Schaefer's at the 20, the 15. Schaefer cuts back inside at the 10. Touchdown, Woodland. Landon Schaefer goes in from 35 yards out. Woodland is just gashing him with the run game.
A couple of nice little juice to take out the finger.
To play before halftime. Woodland leads Fulbright 14-8. And Woodland's come to play tonight.
Yeah. What a run. I mean, that drive, 91 yards. Holy cow. If you're Fulbright, you're going, man, what are we going to do to stop these guys?
Well, all on the ground.
Yeah, and they haven't even thrown the ball.
I don't know. I don't think they've thrown it once.
They have not attempted a pass yet.
Kel Bray, the kicker. We fielded on the hop at the 31-yard line, back across the 40, the 45, across midfield into the Woodland 46-yard line. Trying to strip it out there at the end. Schaefer was on the tackle that time. Nunnally was the return man. 23 on the return, and it'll be first down at the Woodland 46 with 4:09 to play before halftime.
And the danger in that, everybody's trying to strip it. You forget, you got to get the guy down.
Fulbright hasn't really been stopped itself on offense tonight. It was a fumble. That is the biggest play in this game so far. Battles will keep it, and he's got a lot more room across the 45. Breaks a tackle across the 40, the 35, and he's pushed out of bounds at the 34-yard line. Tyree Terry on the tackle.
they send that running back into the hole to kind of clear it out for the quarterback. You don't see that too often. Usually when a quarterback's going to run, they just take off and go, and they don't wait for it. Get a blocker to lead the way. Which most people, I guess, don't have a quarterback that can run like that either.
.353 to play before halftime. First down here for Fulbright from the Woodland 34-yard line. Battles, takes it. Just going to keep it himself. Runs up the middle. Look at this. Across the 30, the 25, and there he goes. He's at the 15, the 10. Touchdown, Fulbright. Wow.
Jeez.
Battles with a 34-yard touchdown run. He's already had runs tonight of 31, 35, and that 34-yarder.
He was the entire drive, both plays.
He caught a couple of Woodland defenders flat-footed up the middle, and then it was just a numbers game. Fulbright had more blockers than Woodland had defenders.
So I guess the question now is, which way is he going to run on this one?
He is an impressive-looking athlete. Wolf lines up behind him, and they run this reverse here, and Greg's going to be taken down to the backfield. Charlie Graves stayed home and took him down. The last time they faked it to Wolf and then threw a little shuffle pass to Greg going across the middle. That time they looked like they were going to run the option left with Wolf and then pitched it to Greg going back across the field. And Charlie Graves did a nice job of staying home, making the tackle. And with 3:43 to play before halftime, we are tied at 14.
Kind of an interesting play call in that it takes a while to develop and you're counting on the defense to sell out. And Graves that time did not, and that made all the difference in the world. Well, it may come down to two-point conversions the way these offenses are rolling up and down the field.
Terry is standing back deep. I'm sorry, that's Burns standing back deep. Also Graves for Woodland. Noah Nunnally is the kicker. It's a line drive kick that Burns will take at the 20-yard line. Back across the 30, Burns is at the 40. Burns has got a man to miss. He's at the midfield, the 45, the 40, and there he goes. He's at the 30, the 25, the 20, the 15, and knocked out of bounds at the 13-yard line.
Wow. Phenomenal job.
What a game Xavier Burns is having. He had a 41-yard return earlier. They're going to mark him out this time at the 15, so that's a return of 65. It's already over 100 return yards for him, not to mention he's had a couple of really nice runs. And he'll go over to the sideline, breathing a little hard. Terry will come out with the offense here on first down as the tailback.
How about this? Starting on your opponent's 15, that's a very nice way to open a possession.
They've started on the Fulbright side of the field twice. The only time they didn't, they went six plays, 91 yards. Schaefer with three receivers left side, one to the right. Now they'll bring a man in motion. Now they bring another. Schaefer takes the snap. He'll hand it to this man going right side. That's Graves across the 10, spins, breaks a tackle at the 5, and falls forward to the 3-yard line.
Nice spin, allowed him to get past the defenders. Unfortunately, that spin kind of took his equilibrium out of play, or else he would have trotted into the end zone.
Gain of 12. It's first and goal for Woodland from the 3. 3:25, and the clock is running before halftime. Woodland trying to go 3-for-3 scoring so far. Scored tonight on a 35-yard touchdown run, a possession ago by Landon Schaefer. Here's the give to Terry, goes outside. He's going to be taken down to the backfield. Big loss back to the 10-yard line. Terry taken down for a loss of 7. Wolf was on the tackle that time for Fulbright.
Just couldn't get around the edge.
You may see them go to the air for the first time here, Blair.
Yeah, be a good time to do it, a little play action.
Clock running, 2:39 to play before halftime. Fulbright and Woodland tied at 14.
And it would appear they are going to take a timeout.
There it is. They let the clock go down to one on the play clock, and they take a timeout with 2:25 to play before halftime. This is Woodland Football, presented by Freedom 5-1 and Eagle Bank Mortgage.
Freedom 5-1, transforming the financial destinies of families with financial life coaching. Chris and Tim encourage you to visit their website, freedom51.com, or visit their page on Facebook at Freedom 5-1. 2468, who has those competitive rates? Eagle Bank Mortgage does. Call Dana Boring with Eagle Bank Mortgage to see if home ownership is right for you. NMLS 419-384, Equal Housing Lender. The same with our two sponsors. You can get a house, and then once you get your house, you can get set up with some financial life coaching, make all those payments, and pay that thing off in no time. Avoid debt.
Relatively speaking.
Take the coaching.
See what kind of coaching Woodland got in that timeout as they come out for a second down and goal from the 10-yard line. Not a lot of negative yardage plays tonight for the Colts. In fact, I think that last run by Tyree Terry was the first time they've been taken down in the background.
Yes.
Or in the backfield, I'm sorry.
It'd be a question of who has the ball last tonight.
Burns is the tailback. Schaefer takes the snap. He fakes it to Burns, and now Schaefer runs right side, trying to hit the sideline, breaks the tackle, and falls forward for a few yards. They'll mark him out at the 7. It'll be third down and goal from there on the tackle that time for Fulbright. It was Peyton Lowry, the linebacker.
Great ball.
Lowry looks like he might be a little shaken up.
Yeah, great ball fake. Nobody was really sure who had it. Woodland's content to run a little clock here.
Taking Lowry straight to the trainer.
Yeah. Just one of the dangers was slowing things down. Your offense could possibly get out of tempo. I guess they're going to take another timeout.
What they're doing, they're going to run this down to the 1 second on the play clock again, which will leave about a minute and a half, maybe a minute 31 to play before halftime. And a minute 31 is where the clock will stop as Woodland takes its second timeout. And what they do here, obviously, I don't want Fulbright to get the ball back
with
too much time.
Part of the chess match, if you will, between the coaching staffs. Always kind of fun to enjoy the different strategies and how everybody reacts. But, I mean, it's pretty critical down. Third and 6 from the 6, so obviously third and goal.
Again, Woodland has not thrown a pass yet tonight.
Which I don't think either team has,
Maybe not.
Run Palooza.
Landon Schaefer is the last one to come out of the timeout for Woodland. Come out with this tight set with a tight end lined up to the, really an H-back, lined up to the left side of the formation. Two receivers to the left. Burns is the tailback. Schaefer fakes it to him. He lost the ball,
oh,
and it's intercepted
goodness.
By Battles. Battles is, might take this back at the 30. Battles is at the 40, and no one's going to catch him. 95-yard interception return for a touchdown. That ball just slipped out of Landon Schaefer's hand and went right to the speediest player on the field.
Unbelievable. What an unfortunate break for the Colts.
Oh, man. It just slipped right out of his hands. And if you're Woodland, that was the last guy you wanted it to end up in his hands.
Well, now you got to stop him on this two-point conversion.
Fulbright's going to take a timeout before the two-point play. They got to get their breath back.
Yeah, and they want to make sure they got the right one called. Because the way it's going tonight, you're going to need every point you can get. Man, what an unfortunate break for the Colts.
Biggest play of the game so far. Christian Battles, who already has touchdown runs tonight of 31 and 34 yards, now with a 95-yard pick six.
Well, you know, nobody feels worse about that than Landon does, mm-hmm. and you can imagine that. We thought he ran hard last week. I got a feeling in the second half we're going to see him run even harder.
Two-point try upcoming with a minute 15 to play before halftime.
I think they just let Battles take it this time instead of trying some misdirection, but we shall see.
They've got two receivers stacked on the left side of the formation. Actually, two receivers stacked on either side. Wolf, the tailback. Battles, play fake, now being pressured, throws, and this pass is intercepted. This is Schaefer. They can't return it, though.
Which is unfortunate.
Otherwise, Schaefer might have taken that back for 2 points.
Oh, there's no question. He would have gone all the way.
How about that? Schaefer throws an interception to Battles, and then Battles throws it right back to Schaefer. The two-point try no good, and Woodland will get it back trailing by six with a minute 15 to play.
A little surprised he was even able to pass the ball. He had a Woodland defender, had him by the arm.
It was Julian Stafford who had pressured him.
Well, a minute 15, they've got a kickoff, and the last two kickoff returns have been very
good. Xavier
Burns
has had a lot of success returning kicks tonight, 41 and 65 yards on his last two returns.
So, they've got plenty of time, another shot to get it in the end zone before halftime.
Still one timeout left for Woodland.
And Fulbright's discussing this because they don't want to give up another big-time return. See, they're not even out there formation yet.
And I wonder if Woodland is expecting them to kick it a different way because Burns and Graves have flipped sides of the field.
Let's see if Fulbright has noticed that as well. They may not have.
Burns is lined up on the right side of the formation the last two times, and this time he lines up on the left side.
It's all well. The way they're lined up, man, it looks like they might even split it or offside it.
Dunnelly. Just a straight-ahead kick. It's a high kick, and it'll be fielded by Graves at the 23-yard line. Charlie Graves back across the 30, the 35, and he falls forward to the 38-yard line after a return of 15.
Well, they noticed it was Charlie over there, and they kicked it to him, and they aligned everybody, and that's they were not going to kick it to Burns. Still a pretty good return. It sets up the offense with good field position with 1:08 to go in the quarter.
A little bit of confusion about who the tailback is going to be here, Burns and Terry, and now Burns is going to stay on as Tyree Terry trots off the field. Two receivers to either side, one of them on the left side in the slot is Caden Kilpatrick. That's the seventh grade quarterback who plays receiver some for the eighth graders. Schaefer in the shotgun on first down. They bring a blitz. That's Battles,
oh
and Schaefer is spun around but gets away. Now running to his left, Landon just trying to make something happen here, and he's going to be taken down back at the 28-yard line. Loss of eight that time for Schaefer. And I think Woodland just took its final timeout.
Took a pretty good lick, too.
Nunnally was credited with the tackle that time, but it's really Battles who blew up that play. Came on a delayed blitz, and Woodland didn't even touch him.
Well, 35 seconds, you probably.
Or Fulbright's got his timeouts, too.
Yeah. Given the length of the field, three plays, maybe. That's what you're kind of rolling with. Going to play soft in the secondary, so you can kind of sneak one in. And now they're going to back up the secondary a little more, it looks like.
Second down and 20. Schaefer just chucks it deep, looking for Graves down the field and just overthrew him. With just a little more touch on that ball, that might have been a touchdown. Graves got behind the defense, but just couldn't pull it in. And that'll be third down and 20 with 28 seconds to play before halftime.
They got the look they wanted. go for a while with everybody playing deep.
On third and 20, they just give it up the middle to Terry across the 30-yard line and out to the 32. Fulbright's got two timeouts if they want to take one. And they do. They take it. A little bit of indecision, but they finally take it with 14 seconds to play before the break. It'll be fourth and long for Woodland. And Fulbright's going to try to get the ball back.
And a little bit of a decision, too, for Woodland. Do you go for it? And doing so, eat some clock, or do you punt it away? Decisions to be made on both sides of the field. Well, it looks like the Colts are going to punt this away.
Wolf is back deep to return for Fulbright. That's Daxton Tesmer, who's lined up to punt it away for Woodland. Standing back at his 21, Wolf is between the 40 and the 45 of the Timberwolves, and looks like they're going to bring the house. He gets it away, Tesmer does. It's a low line drive kick, but it does the job, and it'll be down at the 38-yard line with 5 seconds to play before halftime.
Boy, that is fortunate for Fulbright that they got it down when they did, because if he goes ahead and fair catch it, but just takes it and falls down, they might save 4 or 5 seconds. And they're going to take a timeout, Matt, and set something up with 5 seconds left, and there's no telling.
That's the final timeout of the half for Fulbright. So both teams now out of timeouts.
See what Coach Ruby has in his bag of tricks, because he's going to have to pull it out here. Don't get beat deep. That's the main thing that all the Woodland coaches are telling their linebackers and secondary. Don't let anybody get behind you. But as we've seen over the years, that is always easier said than done.
Fulbright will snap it from its own 48-yard line. They have not thrown the ball yet tonight. Of course, they haven't needed to because Woodland's had such a tough time tackling that quarterback battles.
They only attempted the one pass, and that was on the two-point conversion.
Battles takes the snap, looks left, and now he's just going to run it. Here we go. Trying to get outside, and he's going to be taken down. The ball came out, and Woodland's
loose.
Got it, and there's no time left on the clock.
Battles
fumbled it. It was recovered by the Colts, by Isaac Smith. And that's how the first half will end. Boy, I bet Woodland would like to have that back. I mean, even just 1 second on the clock,
yeah.
You might get a chance to score going into the locker room. Well, it was an entertaining first half. Score, Fulbright 20, Woodland 14. We'll be back in a moment. This is Woodland Football presented by Freedom 5-1 and Eagle Bank Mortgage. Bryant leading Woodland 20-14. Play of the game so far has been Christian Battle's 95-yard pick six return inside the final 2 minutes of the first half.
It wasn't really even a true pass.
Yeah, it was a fluke play.
Schaefer's
trying to throw it on the third goal. The ball just slipped out of his hands and right into the speedy player on the field.
He's trying to pump it.
Not only kicks it out of bounds.
Yeah, that's a bird.
Almost think they might prefer that than letting Xavier Burns get his hands on it.
Well, the way it's been going, it's kind of the lesser of two evils.
So that'll give Woodland the ball at the 35-yard line. Oh, they decline it, so they're going to make them re-kick it.
Yeah.
Strategy there by Bobby Crockett.
Well,
the penalty wouldn't have been declined. It's the portion of the re-kick.
Yeah. Well, I'm saying if he kicks this one out of bounds, and this field, you know.
I just got the official announcement.
Oh, okay.
That's correct. He'll kick this one to 35. Now Burns is going to get his hands on it from the 24. Burns back across the 30. He's had some big returns tonight. And he gets followed up this time and taken down at the 40-yard line.
Saw a hole, but just couldn't get through it. So
good. They end up getting about 5 yards out of that decision. They've got the ball at the 35. And they'll start now at 40. 7:50 play in the third quarter. Woodland has moved the ball really well tonight, especially on the ground. In fact, they haven't completed a pass yet.
I don't think either team's completed a pass. The only one we've seen is on the two-point conversion of Schaefer interception.
Well, Woodland did throw a couple of passes
right.
Toward the end of the half, but really through the first 15 minutes or so, neither team threw a pass. Schaefer to run all the way, going left side across the 45, breaks the tackles, got first down yardage across midfield. Actually, they say he stepped out short of midfield. It'll depend on the spot whether or not he's got the first down. The official's got 1 foot on the midfield stripe and one just on the Woodland side. They put the ball just inside Woodland territory, so that's about 9.87 yards probably. Like Schaefer. About as close as you can get to a first down marker and not have it. Second down. Schaefer gives it. This is Burns. And he's got the first down. The ball came out.
Oh, no.
And Christian Battles can't come up with it. I think Woodland may have gotten it. No?
Maybe.
Nope. Battles got it. Battles got it. Battles trying to scoop it and score. Couldn't get it on his first try. But then he was able to fall back on it. And so now another turnover has given Fulbright great field position. Timberwolves will start at the Woodland 42 with 7:12 to play in the third quarter. Turnovers looming really large in this game right now. Of course, Fulbright had the turnover inside the red zone. That set up a long touchdown drive for Woodland. Now Woodland with a couple of turnovers in his last three drives. Battles with three receivers to the right side. It's a run all the way, going left side across the 40. He just gets great yardage every time he decides to tuck it and run. 9 that time to the 33. It'll be second down and 1.
The defense to rise up here.
Christian Battles is a name to remember player at Bentonville High School here in a few years. Maybe a few is 2. And he's the type of player that, even if he can't get on the field as a quarterback, you're going to find a way to get him somewhere.
Yeah. He's the kind of good. You'll find a place to get the ball in his hand.
Second down and 1. Battles keeps it himself. Running left side. He's got the first down yardage. He's knocked out of bounds after a short run to the 31-yard line.
Bryce Wolf, the running back there, nice job holding up one of the folks so he can get to the edge. He's been blocking his tail off tonight, this quarterback.
I think that was Graves that pushed him out of bounds. Gain of 2. Clock has stopped. 6:07 to play third quarter. big possession in this game, it feels like right here is Woodland's trailing by six already. Battles. Gives it to Wolf. Wolf with a good run across the 25 and down to the 23-yard line. Gain of eight. It seems like both of these teams, when they're not fumbling the ball, did six, seven, eight, sometimes 20, 30 yards per carry.
Oh, yes. Kind of reminiscent of the old Miss Alabama game. You're always leery of a team that has a wide receiver going up while everybody else is.
Yeah. Paddle's running right side, trying to get to the edge. He's got it across the 20, and then he's going to be taken down at the 18-yard line. That was Tesmer on the tackle for Woodland.
Great job by Tesmer.
The wrap up. Six on the carry to the 17-yard line, though. Clock running, 5:21 to play third quarter. Fulbright trying to add to a 20-14 lead. Got down in the red zone in the second quarter and fumbled the ball away. Would like to see that happen again. Battles for as good as he's been. He's fumbled a couple of times. This time he's going to be hit in the backfield and taken down by Julian Stafford. Stafford hit him in the backfield, took him down for a loss of a yard. And it'll be second and 11, 4:51, clock running.
Nice job by the defense. Really keying in on Battles running once they get him in the red zone. It's a little harder.
Fulbright taking its time. Getting ready to snap it from the 18 on second and 11. Battles to give the Wolf up the middle, and he's not going to get much down to the 16. Looks like that might have been Stafford that got his hands on him.
Yeah.
No, that was Hayden Bowerman, number 88.
Yeah, Wolf thought he was going to get past Bowerman. Bowerman kind of grabbed him and said, no, he's coming back to the place, right?
Bowerman and Stafford have played pretty well in the interior of the defensive line for Wolf this year. Stafford, in the 50, has particularly stood out. Interesting situation, third down and nine. Battles runs left side, and now he's going to be taken down to the backfield. Landon Schaefer hit him, took him down for a loss of four back to the 20, and now it's fourth down. And it looks, Blair, like Woodland is starting to key on the run because they're not expecting Fulbright to throw any passes.
No.
And that makes this an interesting dynamic as it's fourth down and 13.
Now what do?
Can Fulbright make the play through the air?
Yep, forcing the pass.
Big play in this game, 3:09 to play, clock running third quarter. Looks like Fulbright may take a timeout and discuss his play.
Yeah.
I'm going to run this play clock all the way down to 1 second. And there's the timeout, 2:53 to play in the third quarter.
Interesting decision time here. Coach Ruby. Yeah, they have those two wide receivers. I mean, they don't even go to the huddle. They just line up on the line. It's just like they're decoys.
Reminds you a little bit of Gus Malzahn's offense. You see that a lot of times where the receivers will run out while the lineman and the quarterback, maybe the running back, can stay in the huddle. The difference is we don't see a lot of quick snaps like you see in that type of offense.
Or the motion.
Right.
You got to totally sell up.
Fourth down and 13 for Fulbright. They're at the 20. They need to get to the Woodland 7. Two receivers left side. Battles the quarterback. He's a left-hander. Goes play action. Throws left side. That pass is batted and incomplete. Landon Schaefer came through and deflected it. And Woodland's going to get the turnover on downs. Big time stop that time for the Colts. give themselves a chance here late in the third quarter.
And a big time pass breakout by Mr. Schaefer. All right, so now an opportunity to get the ball back and take the lead with the score.
The second time that Fulbright has come away empty handed inside the red zone tonight.
And the last time the Colts had to start deep in their own end and marched all the way down 91 yards.
They'll start this drive with 2:49 to play third quarter. Schaefer, three receivers to his left side. Burns is a tailback. Schaefer fakes it to him. Now runs beside Burns, left side across the 25, and he's near the first down marker. Well, depending on the spot, he's got it. 10-yard pickup that time by Schaefer to the 30. That'll move the chains.
Nice run. Well, they're starting to worry about the pass, too. They had a couple of cornerbacks drop back further.
Burns still the tailback. We approach 2.5 minutes to play third quarter. With a man in motion from right to left. Schaefer gives it to Burns. Burns, good run across the 35, falls forward to the 38-yard line. He'll mark it at the 39. Gain of 9, they bring up second down and 1. Looks like Blair of Woodland wants 9 yards. They can get it on the ground.
Yeah, they're doing such a great job at first down, too. Setting up second short. Really haven't done a whole lot through the air, but there's that stuff. That's just keeping full breath until we sell out to try and stop the run.
Four receivers on the second down and 1. Schaefer balls on the ground, and Terry just has to fall on it for a loss of 2 back to the 37-yard line.
And that's been the thing that's undone the court tonight.
So now it's at a second down and 1. It'll be third down and 3 for Woodland. Ball has hit the turf quite a bit tonight on both sides. Three receivers to the right side. That's the open side of the field. Give it to Burns, running left side. He's got the first down across the 40, the 45, and falls forward near midfield. 13 on the carry that time for Burns. They will mark him at the 50. Kind of interesting to see this player. They've got a kicker over on the, almost behind the Woodland.
Oh, yeah, there he is.
Bleachers. Warming up. We saw it at halftime. Yeah. I think you can extra point here. Obviously, they have to score a touchdown first, but he put him up by a point. Schaefer goes play action on first down, then has to keep it himself. That was a coverage sack.
Didn't get around the end.
Bentonville Fano, number 34, made the tackle. Not really a sack, it would be a run for no gain. Second down and 10. Maybe the last play of the quarter here. 18 seconds. Schaefer keeps it himself, right left side across the 45, the 40. He's at the 35. There he goes, at the 30, the 25, the 20. Schaefer's at the 10 and falls forward. It'll be first and goal for the Colts. Where do they mark him out? They mark him out at the 4-yard line.
Yeah, okay.
Is there a flag? There is a flag. It's a hold against Woodland. There's a flag back at the 35-yard line. That's well downfield too, Blair. That's 15 yards from the line of scrimmage. So it'll be a 10-yard penalty from the where the flag was dropped, but it'll still be a 5-yard gain.
Man, that was a great run by them.
Again, they're using pink flags tonight. They're very difficult to see. That one was off right in front of the Woodland bench. And now there's some confusion with the chain game.
Yeah, there.
actually they're 15 yards off. They should come back to midfield.
Yeah.
And then they still don't have the chains in the right position.
Right.
And I'm not sure if the officials even noticed this.
No.
They got a. Well, that's the empty quarter. Hold on. Yeah, they're asking for 8 seconds to go back onto the clock.
The chains are still not there.
No, they're not. It should be second down and 5.
Yeah.
But it's almost as if they're saying this is the first down and 10. Better result for Woodland.
Yeah.
All right, first down. Schaefer gets it to Graves, across the 40. Graves runs into an official, then falls forward to the 34-yard line. Well, after all the confusion, that is for sure a first down.
Yeah.
That's going to be the final play of the third quarter, I think.
Yeah,
there's 1 second left on the clock. It'll wind after they move the chains, and there it is. 3 quarters are in the book here. At Tiger Stadium, Woodland trailing Fulbright 20-14, but the Colts are marching. Back after this, this is Woodland football presented by Freedom 5-1 and Englebank Mortgage. Getting ready to start the fourth quarter, Woodland and Fulbright. Colts trail the Timberwolves 20-14. They have a first down on the Fulbright side of the field from the 34-yard line. Graves is a tailback, Schaefer is the quarterback. 3 receivers to the right side. That's the open side of the field. Schaefer gives it to Graves across the 30. Graves has got a big hole across the 25, and it closed fast, but he's got first down yardage down to the 22-yard line. Graves has carried the last 2 times for gains of 11 and 12. And it'll be first down and 10 from the 22. 7:41 to play fourth quarter.
Colts trying to take the lead.
Blair, based on what we've seen, we expect them to try to kick an extra point if they can get in the end zone. Here's the give to Graves again. That time, not much there. Gain of a yard to the 21. That was Ryan Self on the tackle for Fulbright.
And a few times on first down, they've not gained at least, what, 7?
Yeah. Yeah, it's usually been pretty consistent that they're looking at anywhere from a second down and 1 to a second down and 3. And that's if they don't get a first down on first down like Charlie Graves did a minute ago. A man in motion from the right to the left. Schaefer, it's a run left all the way. Breaks a tackle across the 20. Breaks another at the 15. Is it the 10? The 5 dives for the pylon. I don't think he got there. They're going to mark him out at the half-yard line.
Great blocking on the left side.
20-yard pickup that time by Schaefer. It was a run all the way. And we've talked a lot about battles, the quarterback for Fulbright, and how well he's run tonight. But Schaefer's run really well, too.
Yes. Don't overlook him. Looked like they might have had him momentarily behind the line of scrimmage, but he was able to shed that blocker and follow that tackle and follow his blockers.
Very rarely does the first defender bring him down. First and goal from the 1. They move a tight end to the left side of the formation. Schaefer takes the snap, gives it to Burns, runs up the middle, and I don't know if he got it.
No.
Bottled up,
close.
And he's going to be taken down. It'll be second down coming up from inside the 1-yard line. Clock runs, 6:26 to play.
Trying to catch him off guard with a handoff, because I think they were expecting Schaefer to take it all the way that time. We'll see if he does here.
kind of feels like the moment where he takes it and keeps it himself. There it is. Takes it up the middle. Touchdown, yep. Woodland. We may have seen that play once or twice this year. Landon Schaefer fakes it to Burns, goes up the middle for a yard. And with 6:07 to play, it's tied at 20. And Woodland's going to try an extra point.
Yep.
We haven't seen this too many times this year, Blair. This is Noah Smith on to attempt the extra point. We saw him practicing at halftime, saw him practicing on the sidelines a moment ago, and it's blocked by Battles. Spins on the ground, and that can't be returned. Christian Battles just continues to have a great game in all three phases tonight for Fulbright.
Wow.
And so the game remains tied at 20 with 6:07 to go.
What can this kid not do? Holy cow. He must have been selling something. Probably working the concession stand at halftime. I mean, he has just been everywhere. And that wasn't a tip block either. I mean,
he just ran right through. Yep.
Well.
Not sure anybody put a hand on him. Kind of like when he, almost like when he runs the ball.
Yeah.
It's just so hard to bring him down.
Mm.
And it seems like so many times when he runs the ball, Woodland players are in good position. It's just he's so fast that there's that split second between what you see and how you react. And by the time you make that reaction, he's past you a lot of times.
Yeah. Well, that's kind of tough, too, for the guys on that special teams unit. You're so used to going for two. I'm sure they practice it, but it's just not the same as a game. So this is a big – well, this is an interesting formation on the kickoff.
Battles tonight, two touchdown runs, had a pick six, and now he's blocked an extra point.
Well, if you want to now there they go. I was going to say, if they're going to be tight like that, it's just daring you to kick one on side.
Bray will kick it away for Woodland. It takes a bounce. That's a live ball back at the 25-yard line. Here comes Fulbright trying to make something happen, and they're not going to get anything. Out to the 27-yard line on the return that time was Bodie Geist, I'm sorry.
I think it was Isaac Smith with the tackle, or was that Terry? But nice special teams tackle.
6 minutes to play. Fulbright and Woodland tied at 20. This has been the most entertaining game we've had this year between the 8th graders.
6 minutes left to go. Fulbright will probably try to use as much of that up as they can.
Battles, it's a run all the way going right side, and Woodland read that really well. No gain back to the 27. That was Rhett Tidwell on the tackle for Woodland. They do give him a yard. The line of scrimmage was at the 26 that time. Second down and 9, clock running, 5.5 minutes to play. Woodland and Fulbright tied at 20. Big game here. Winner tonight as the inside track playing for a conference championship. Here's Battles again, runs right into the teeth of that defense again. And take it down for no gain. That's Caden Kilpatrick, the 7th grader. Woodland is selling out to stop the run right now, and all they're doing is watching Christian Battles.
And so far, it's working.
It's worked on about 4 or 5 plays in a row. Let's play action or watch Wolf here. On third down, they're going left side. The pass is caught. This is Nunnally. Tries to break tackles, but he can't. Out to the 30. Really sure tackling that time. Landon Schaefer on the tackle for the Colts. Also in on the tackle was Mathis Brady, and now it'll be fourth down, and Fulbright, it would be pretty gutsy to go for it here.
Boy,
from the 30. Decision time. They line up as if they're going to go for it. They could also pooch it from here, and I think now Battles has stepped back far enough that that's what they're going to do. Right-footed kick for the lefty passer. Graves fields it at the 25. Graves back across the 30. Takes some defenders with him to the 34-yard line. That's where Woodland will begin, first and 10 with 3:53 to play. Blair, I was kind of taken aback by that. He throws left-handed, and he kicked right-footed.
Yeah, that just didn't look right.
It's like the first baseman who bats from the left and throws from the right.
Well, that could have been. It was a good return because it looked like for a moment that ball was going to get away from him.
Good job by Graves that time to have the presence of mind to pick it up and say, we can get some field position out of this.
Yeah, made a nice little return.
Clock is running. Three receivers left side for Schaefer on first down from the Woodland 34. Schaefer keeps it himself, running across the right side, the 45, tries to break a tackle, and he's going to go down at about midfield.
Nice run.
16 yards. And they'll mark it right at the 50. Blair, I don't know if I've ever seen a game where we've had more times where the ball has been placed exactly on the 50-yard line than this game tonight.
That's true. It has happened a lot. Leonard does such a good job on that, selling that handoff to the running back.
Clock is running, 3:17 to play. Woodland doesn't have to really be in any hurry here. They give it to Terry. Tyree Terry trying to run left side, then cuts back up the field. Gets 5, gets 6, maybe 7 yards down to the 43-yard line.
Well, that was a nifty little run. He saw that the edge was not going to be available and cut back. Picks up 6. Another big first down play for Woodland.
Ball is between the 43 and the 44-yard line. Colts need to get to the 40 of Fulbright. 2:38, clock still running. Kind of feels like Woodland's going to score here, or nobody's going to score at all. Terry's going right side, now tries to cut back up, and not only got him by the ankles and took him down for a loss. Loss of about half a yard as Noah Nunnally took him down behind the line of scrimmage. And now it's third down and 4.
Big, big third down here for the Colts. I'm a little surprised neither team's using the timeout.
Woodland makes some substitution changes. They bring in Luke Robley at receiver. And they bring in Burns at tailback on 3rd and 4. Oh, they're going to go a reverse. This is Graves going right side across the 40. Charlie Graves has got the first down to the 36-yard line. Nifty play call there.
Very.
They gave it to Burns running left. To give it back to Graves running right. Landon Schaefer, the quarterback, got out in front of him as a lead blocker. Clock still running. 1:39 to play.
I'm surprised Fulbright didn't take the timeout.
Fulbright has 2 timeouts. Woodland has 3. Now the Colts have milked the clock so much, they got to start moving here.
Yeah.
From the 36, first down. Schaefer being blitzed. Throwing right side. He's got a man down there, and that pass is incomplete, but a flag is on the field.
Broken up.
It's going to be interference against Nunnally. I believe that was Brady, was the intended receiver on the right sideline. It was Mathis Brady. There's the pass interference call. And that'll put Woodland inside the 25-yard line. They'll park the ball at the 21 with 1:18 to play.
Well, it's really not a bad penalty for Fulbright because he would have caught it at the 10.
First down from the 21, just 1:18 to go. Schaefer going to keep it himself, running right side. He's across the 15. He's at the 10. Schaefer tries to get away, and he's knocked out of bounds. It'll be first down and goal at the 9-yard line. A gain of 12, and only a second came off the clock.
Wow. That's what happens when you're on the road.
There was 1:18 on the clock when that play began, and 1:17 when it ended.
He's fast. I guess is the only way you can explain that. What a run. And this is where Landon is just money down here. But he's running the ball.
It almost feels like they just want it to stay in his hands.
Yes.
He's so sure-handed. He does a good job of getting yards after contact. And he's tall, and a lot of times you see him fall forward for a couple of extra yards.
He runs so hard. I mean, quarterbacks normally don't run that hard.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's almost Tebow-esque in a way. I mean, he will run over.
Be Sam Ellinger for
modern-day
college. It'll be first and goal for Woodland from the 9. Minute 17 to play. Fulbright took the timeout, so there's only one timeout remaining now for the Timberwolves. 3 still left for the Colts. This Fulbright snap doesn't want the clock to run down on them, and they don't get any time left.
Yeah. You want to work clock, but you also want to pound that thing in the end zone.
Terry is the tailback. There's two receivers to the right side. That's the near side of the field. Schaefer on first and goal from the 9. It's a run all the way. Schaefer keeps it up the middle, across the 5, still churning, down to the 4-yard line, and they'll mark him at the 3. Fulbright's not taking its time out here as we go under a minute to play.
Yeah, I don't know if they'll get the ball back.
There's about a 30-second differential between the play clock and the game clock. Woodland's still got all of its timeouts if they want to. They can run this play clock down and still have a few chances from inside the 5. 8 on the play clock. They take the snap. The give. Left side. Terry falls down. Terry slipped almost from the time he got that football and falls down at the 2-yard line. And now Woodland's going to take its first timeout with 30 seconds left.
So you got 2 plays.
Interesting decision there, Blair. They probably could have taken it down for another 10 seconds or so. And I mean, you got to score here within the next 2 plays. There's no doubt about it. But the way Fulbright can score, kind of hate to give them the ball back with any time left on the clock.
Yeah, you got 2 shots to go 2 yards. You want to make sure you get the right play. You don't want anybody to be rushed.
The scoreboard says Fulbright has 2 timeouts left. I believe that is incorrect. I think they've got 1 left.
And Woodland should have 2.
That was Woodland's first timeout of the half. You almost wonder if Woodland doesn't make it here. Assuming Fulbright doesn't take a timeout, if you're Woodland, maybe do you run it down to 1 second to try to score on the last play of the game?
Yeah, that's a possibility. Here we go.
Do you dare try to kick a field goal after Christian Battles blocking that last one?
Boy, it makes you think.
Graves is a tailback on 3rd down and goal from the 2-yard line. Schaefer in the shotgun. He's got 4 receivers, 2 to either side. Schaefer takes the snap. Is hitting the backfield on a quarterback keeper, and he's not going to get there. In fact, he may have lost a yard, maybe a yard and a half, back between the 3 and the 4-yard line. And now somebody's taking a timeout. It's Woodland.
Woodland, yeah.
With 21 seconds left. Interesting decision there.
Yeah.
But regardless of what happens on this next play, Fulbright's going to get the ball back with some time on the clock.
Correct. It's been a heck of a ball game, too. Wow. 21 seconds, they go 2 yards. Boy,
you put it in the air here?
Boy,
Fulbright selling out to stop the run.
They are selling out to stop the run. May not be a bad idea, or what you could do, you could roll Landon out one way and have some guys there in the end zone who can throw or pass. Obviously, throw or pass, it's the same thing, but he can throw or he can run.
Yeah.
Kind of
quarterback.
A PRO.
Yeah. Some quarterbacks throw and some quarterbacks pass.
That's true. Or you can run a little shovel pass. I mean, who knows?
Yeah.
There's all sorts of nuts.
Well, they've got their call.
Yeah.
Schaefer and the offense coming back out of the huddle. The ball is between the 3 and the 4-yard line. There's 21 seconds remaining. Woodland trying to cap off what would easily be its biggest win of the year. They punt it in here. They got a score here. It's fourth down.
You roll them out left.
Three receivers to the left side. Graves is the tailback. One receiver to the right. Now they move Graves in motion from the left to the right. Schaefer takes the snap, fakes it to Graves, running right side. It's a run all the way, and he's not going to get there. Fulbright was ready for it. A.J. Looney with the tackle that time at the five-yard line. And Woodland comes away empty-handed inside the red zone with 15 seconds remaining.
Well,
such a promising drive bogs down inside the five-yard line. And now Fulbright with a timeout left and 15 seconds on the clock. We'll start from its own five. We'll see what they decide to do.
Oh, they're winding the clock now. I don't know if Fulbright.
They're not going to take a snap.
No.
Coaches come out on the field, tell them to hold it.
Interesting.
3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second. That's the end of regulation. All right.
So.
Overtime.
First time this year?
Yes.
Now, is this the high school overtime? We start at the 25?
No, I think it's the 10.
Oh, the 10. Yeah, that's right. 10.
At AAA, you start at the 10.
Well.
You have some marathon overtimes, too, from the 10-yard line, let me tell you.
Yes. And the way this is going, we might be here a while.
Well, it really comes down to the two-point plays.
Yes, which kind of is the difference in this one, you know?
Well, if you're Woodland, you might be a little concerned after the way that drive went inside the 10-yard line.
Yeah. Looks like we're headed.
So here comes the coin toss. Landon Schaefer and Christian Battles, they're the two stars of this game, the quarterbacks, will represent their teams.
First of many battles, I'm sure, between these two still to come.
It appears that Woodland won the toss. Yeah, Woodland won the toss. And so Fulbright gets to decide which side of the field they want to go toward. And they're going to go toward that Tiger Athletic Center, their big indoor football facility on the north side of the stadium where Woodland was just stopped on fourth down.
Well, the winds died down, so that's not going to be a factor. And even if it was, I think the tack's going to block anything that rises up.
So Fulbright will go on offense first. Woodland, by winning the coin toss, picks defense.
What's your preference on that? Which do you want?
I understand why teams go on defense first, to let you know what you've got to do. Although when you're talking about a junior high and kicking is such a, it's an absolute luxury in junior high. I'm not so sure that it really matters just a whole lot. All right, Battles on first down. It's overtime in Bentonville. Been a long night. Battles, he knew this was coming. He keeps it himself and runs right into Patterson. No gain. Great tackle that time by Desarian Patterson. It'll be second down. Woodland has really done a good job after halftime of keying in on Christian Battles and not letting him get much past the line of scrimmage.
Well, and I think they're going to continue with that. They're going to dare them to throw the football.
Three receivers to the left side for Battles. Wolf stands behind him on second down. Battles running right side, and he's going to be taken down after a gain of five. They'll say he's down at the 6-yard line. Looks like Patterson might have been the one to take him down again.
Yeah, I believe you're correct. Yeah, I would be stunned if they throw it. I mean, they haven't thrown it really all night. I don't know if you're going to throw it once you get inside the inside the five.
Fulbright hasn't scored since the second quarter. In fact, their last touchdown was the pick six by Battles right before halftime. On third down from the six-yard line, Battles, it's going to be a run all the way again. And Schaefer, did he take that ball away, Blair?
It's hard
Landon Schaefer has his hands on the ball, and they're going to say it's down at the seven-yard line. I thought Schaefer might have had the ball in his hands.
Schaefer on the stop. For a moment. Battles may have just wrestled it back from him.
It's fourth down.
Yep.
This Woodland defense has figured things out since the end of the first half. Great halftime adjustments by Coach Crockett and his staff.
Oh, definitely.
Here we go, fourth down. What do you do from the seven-yard line? Battles looking to throw toward the end zone, and that pass is incomplete. He was looking for Nunnally, and Nunnally couldn't come up with it. And now all Woodland has to do is score, and they'll come out of here a winner.
Did that ball get tipped?
I don't think it did. It was on the coverage that time for Woodland was Isaac Smith, but I don't think Smith touched it.
I thought maybe it might have gotten tipped at the line. There were a lot of hands up in the air.
It was a low throw.
Yeah, that's the thing. When a team doesn't pass much, and then you start passing down there where the throwing lanes are just not very big, that's putting a lot of pressure on the quarterback. All right.
The touchdown wins it for Woodland here. They couldn't punch it in from this spot on the field a moment ago. We're getting trying to do over here. Terry's the tailback. Three receivers right side. Schaefer. Look at Graves. One-on-one coverage to the left. They give it to Terry. Running right. Tyree tries to cut up the field, and he's going to be taken out of bounds at the eight. Nunnally on the tackle that time for Fulbright. A touchdown wins it for Woodland. In this game so big in their conference standings. Fulbright hasn't lost this year. Woodland's lost once. Schaefer keeps it himself up to five. Touchdown, Woodland! Schaefer goes in from 8 yards out, and the Colts have won.
How about that? Well, I guess we're going to have the extra point attempt.
Yeah, probably for points purposes and tiebreakers in the standing. Woodland has won the game. The Colts have got to go for two here. But what a big win tonight for the Colts.
Or maybe not. Nope.
And they're not going to go for it. That's it. Game's over. And look at those players celebrating over on the far sideline. What a win tonight by Woodland.
Well, hold on. Now the debate is whether or not.
Do you have to go for two? Yeah. Do you have to go for the extra point? Do you have to go for two?
And
it looks like they are now.
Yep.
Some confusion here by the officials. Those kids just want to celebrate.
Okay.
You're going to give them the play call.
Yeah.
Those kids just want to celebrate. They want to get back on the bus and take that 30-minute ride home. It'll be a happy bus ride for them. What a game by Landon Schaefer tonight.
Yes. And Woodland's going to take a timeout as a result.
Fulbright had the ball inside the red zone early in the third quarter, leading 20-14. And you felt like if they scored there, it might be too much for Woodland to overcome. And at that point, the Woodland defense bowed up. And I don't know that Fulbright got another first down the rest of the game.
No. They just changed the plan to stop Battles at all costs. And
it worked.
It paid off.
Yes, it did.
Time.
Battles really gave Fulbright new life with the blocked extra point. Otherwise, assuming that kick was good, we wouldn't have even gone to overtime.
True.
So here comes the two-point try. Woodland's won the game. Schaefer in the shotgun. They'll run this reverse again. Charlie Graves trying to get to the right side. Now cuts up the middle. Charlie's still running hard, but he's not going to score.
The two-point conversion
Ball game's over. Woodland wins 26-20. What a great game tonight by the Colts to come to Benton County and beat a really, really solid Fulbright team that had not lost all year.
Yeah, so now
Now Woodland has a tiebreaker over Fulbright in the conference standings.
Which is going to be huge.
Huge, yes. Grimsley still undefeated. Of course, Grimsley beat Woodland earlier this year. Things could still get a little dicey. You know, I mean, Woodland still has to play Kirksey. They still have to play George. Fulbright could still beat Grimsley when they play him here at the end of the year. But what a great game tonight by Woodland. They come on the road, and they beat the best team in their conference, arguably, 26-20. With maybe the best half of football they played all season.
Oh, no question about it. That was a phenomenal performance tonight. What some great adjustments at halftime.
And their defense, which had three shutouts at the beginning of the year, didn't give up a touchdown, I think, until the third quarter of their fourth game. It'd been a little shaky the last couple of weeks, and tonight, after halftime, they kind of regained that mojo that they had early in the year.
Yes, they did. They looked very much like their defense we saw at the start of the year. And boy, this is such a big win, confidence booster.
So Woodland will be back on the road next Thursday night. They're going to play at Rogers Kirksey. That game is at Smith Stadium at Rogers High School.
Yes.
5:30 for the 7th grade game. Of course, the 8th grade game will follow 15 minutes after that one ends. We thank you for joining us tonight. What a great win tonight by the Woodland Colts. 26-20 over Fulbright in overtime. From Bentonville for Blair Cartwright, I'm Matt Jones. Have a great night, everyone.